Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 14 on Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. The topic is Fan Overflow Problems Part 1. In the earlier lectures, we discussed about the fan overflow, fan curve, property variation in the fan overflow and variation of Mach number with the duct length. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem in the fan overflow using the gas tables. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the fan overflow. Example number 1, air flows through a duct with a constant cross-sectional area. The pressure temperature and the Mach number at inlet to the duct are 180 kPa, 30 degrees Celsius and 0.25 respectively. If the Mach number at the outlet is raised to 0.75 as a result of friction, determine pressure, temperature, velocity at exit and stagnation pressure loss. Assume that the flow is adiabatic. We are given the inlet pressure 180 kPa, T1. Temperature 30 degrees Celsius and Mach number M1 0.25, Mach number M2 0.75. We take the properties of air, gamma equal to 1.4 and R equal to 287 joules per kilogram Kelvin. From isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 28, at the Mach number M1 equal to 0.25 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take the property P1 by PO1 equal to 0.957. Now the stagnation pressure at the inlet, so PO1 equal to, from this equation, PO1 equal to 180, P1 equal to 180 kPa, 180 divided by 0.957 equal to 188.1 kPa. The velocity at inlet, so C1 equal to M1 into square root of gamma RT1. So substituting C1 equal to, M1 is 0.25, square root of 1.4 into 287 into 303 equal to 87.2 meters per second. And from fan overflow table, page number 6.2, page 81 and 82. So for M1 equal to 0.25 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take P by P star, T by T star, PO by PO star. So P is the pressure at the given condition 1, temperature is T1 and PO1, PO star, T star and P star the choking properties at the choking condition. M1 equal to 0.25, P by P star equal to 4.3165, 1.185, 2.4065. 0.25 is not directly available, 0.24 and 0.26 is available, we have to take the average of these two values. And the 0.75 is directly available, we can take the properties. So take the value from the gas tables, fan overflow table, table number 6.2, page number 81 and 82. Now properties at the exit, P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star. So P2 by P1 we can write as P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star. So P2 equal to P1 into the two ratios. So 180 into 1.385 divided by 4.3165 equal to 57.75 kPa. And similarly PO2, PO1 into PO2 by PO star divided by PO1 by PO star equal to 188.1 into 1.0625 divided by 2.4065 equal to 79.95 kPa. T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T star divided by T1 by T star equal to 303 into 1.079 divided by 1.185 equal to 275.9 Kelvin. And velocity at the exit, C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.75 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 275.9 equal to 249.7 meters per second. The stagnation pressure loss, delta PO equal to PO1 minus PO2, which is 188.1 minus 79.75 equal to 108.15 kPa. So the answer to the problem, pressure at the exit, P2 equal to 57.75 kPa. Temperature at the exit T2 equal to 275.9 Kelvin, velocity at the exit C2 equal to 249.7 meters per second, and stagnation pressure loss delta PO equal to 108.15 kPa. Example number 2, air flow through a 5 cm diameter pipe. Measurements indicate that at the inlet to the pipe, the velocity is 70 meters per second, temperature is 80 degrees Celsius and pressure is 1 megapascal. Find the temperature, pressure and Mach number at the exit of the pipe if the pipe is 25 meter long. Assume that the flow is adiabatic and that mean friction coefficient is 0.005. So we are given diameter equal to 5 cm, C1 equal to 70 meters per second, T1 equal to 80 degrees Celsius, P1 equal to 1 megapascal, length equal to 25 meter and friction coefficient F equal to 0.005. So the Mach number at inlet, from the given data, we calculate the Mach number at inlet, M1 equal to C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, 70 divided by 1.4 into 287 into 353 equal to 0.19. Now from the fan flow table, table number 6.2, page number 81, we take Mach number is 0.19, gamma equal to 1.4, P1 by P star, T1 by T star, 4FL max 1 divided by D. So the values are 5.716. 1.191 and 16.538. Now for the fan of flow, we have derived this equation 4FL divided by D equal to 4FL1 L max 1 divided by D minus 4FL max 2 divided by D. 4FL max by D at Mach number 1, 4FL max by D at Mach number 2. So substituting the values here, 4FL 4 into 0.005 into 25 divided by 0.05 equal to 16.538 minus 4FL max 2 divided by 2 divided by D. Now solving this value, 4FL max by D, FL max 2 by D equal to 6.538. Now from the referring to the fan of flow table, for the above value, 4FL max by D equal to 6.538, we will get, this is the known value 6.538. For this 6.538, we refer back to the table. We take M2 equal to 0.2775. P2 by P star equal to 3.92. T2 by T star equal to 1.1814. And we have to be very careful here. So the M2 value depending on the inlet Mach number. If the inlet Mach number, so here the inlet Mach number is 0.19. So this is subsonic condition. Inlet Mach number is 0.19, the subsonic condition. So the exit Mach number also in the subsonic condition higher than the previous value. If the inlet Mach number is supersonic condition, for the same value, you have to take the supersonic Mach number. That you have to be very careful. Depending on the flow conditions, you have to refer the table carefully. So now M2 equal to 0.2775 and P2 by P star equal to 3.92, T2 by T star equal to 1.1814. Now the properties at the exit, P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star equal to 100 into 3.92 divided by 5.761 equal to 680.4 kilopascal. And T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T star divided by T1 by T star equal to 353 into 1.1814 divided by 1.191 equal to 350.17 Kelvin. The answer to the problem, Mach number at the exit M2 equal to 0.2775. Pressure at exit P2 equal to 680.4 kilopascal. Temperature at exit T2 equal to 350.17 Kelvin. Example 3. Air at an inlet temperature of 60 degrees Celsius with the subsonic velocity flows through an insulated pipe having an inside diameter 5 cm and length 5 meter. The pressure at exit of the pipe is 101 kilopascal and the flow is choked at the end of the pipe. If the average friction factor is 0.005, determine the Mach number, mass flow rate, and change in temperature and pressure through the pipe. So we are given T1 equal to 60 degrees Celsius, L equal to 5 meter, diameter D equal to 5 centimeter, the pressure at exit choking condition P star equal to 101 kilopascal and F friction factor equal to 0.005. The value 4FL max by D, we calculate the FL max by D, 4 into 0.005 into 5 divided by 0.05 equal to 2. Now from the fan of flow table 6.2, page number 81, at 4FL max by D equal to 2, we take the properties. So this is what the value given, we calculated, this is the known value, red color shading is the known value, all the other values we have taken from the table. Mach number is 0.42, where gamma equal to 1.4, P by P star equal to 2.563, T by T star equal to 1.159. And we take the properties at the exit, P equal to 2 properties and inlet, sorry, properties and inlet, P equal to 2.563 into P star. 2.563 into P star equal to 2.563 into 101 equal to 258.86 kilopascal. Temperature of the air at exit, T star equal to T by 1.159 equal to 333 divided by 1.159 equal to 287.3 kelvin. And density of the air at inlet, rho equal to P by RT, 258.86 divided by 287 into 333 equal to 2.71 kilograms per meter cube. Velocity of the air at inlet, C equal to M into square root of gamma RT, which is 0.42 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 333 equal to 153.6 meters per second. Now the mass flow rate, M equal to rho into pi by 4 d square into C, which is 2.71, rho equal to 2.71 into pi by 4 into 0.05 square into 153.6 equal to 0.817 kilograms per second. Change in the pressure, delta P equal to P minus P star, 258.86 minus 101 equal to 157.86 kilopascal. And change in temperature, delta T equal to T minus T star, which is 333 minus 287.3 equal to 45.7 kelvin. Now answer to the problem, Mach number at inlet 0.42, mass flow rate M equal to 0.817 kilograms per second, change in temperature through the pipe 45.7 kelvin, change in pressure through the pipe 157.86 kilopascal. Example number 4, air flow through a 0.15 and 0.25 meter rectangular duct. Mach number, pressure and temperature at certain section of the duct are found to be 2,75 kilopascal and 5 degrees Celsius respectively. Mach number equal to 2, pressure is 75 kilopascal and temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. Assuming the mean friction factor as 0.006, find the maximum length of the duct. Also find the exit pressure and temperature that will exist with this maximum length of the duct. So we are given the size of the duct equal to 0.15 meter and 0.25 meter, Mach number equal to 2, pressure equal to 75 kilopascal, temperature equal to 5 degrees Celsius and friction factor F equal to 0.006. The hydraulic diameter of the rectangular duct, so DH equal to 4 into cross-sectional area divided by perimeter. So 4 into 0.15 into 0.25 divided by 4 into 0.15 plus 0.25 equal to 0.1875 meter. Now from the fan of flow table number 6.2, page number 84, we take M equal to 2 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take the properties P by P star equal to 0.408, P by T star equal to 0.667, 4FL max by D equal to 0.305. Now from the properties, we calculate the pressure at exit equal to P star, because it is choking condition, P star equal to P by 0.408 equal to 75 divided by 0.408 equal to 183.8 kilopascal. Temperature at exit, T star equal to T divided by 0.667 equal to 278 divided by 0.667 equal to 416.79 kelvin. Now the maximum length of the duct, L max equal to 0.305 into DH divided by 4F. 0.305 into 0.1875 divided by 4 into 0.006 equal to 2.38 meter. The answer to the problem, maximum length L max equal to 2.38 meter, pressure at exit P star equal to 183.8 kilopascal, temperature at the exit T star equal to 416.79 kelvin. Air flows through a 12 meter long pipe which has diameter of 25 millimeter. At the inlet to the pipe, the air velocity is 80 meters per second, pressure is 350 kilopascal and temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. If the mean friction factor is 0.005, find the velocity, pressure, temperature and temperature at the end of the pipe. Assume the flow is adiabatic. We are given length equal to 12 meter, diameter equal to 25 millimeter, C1 equal to 80 meters per second, pressure P1 equal to 350 kilopascal and the temperature T1 equal to 50 degrees Celsius, the friction factor is 0.005. Mach number at inlet, we calculate the Mach number at inlet, C1 divided by square root of gamma RT1, 80 divided by 1.4 into 287, R equal to 1287 into 323 equal to 0.22. So from the fan of flow table number 6.2, page number 81, Mach number equal to 0.22 and gamma equal to 1.4. We take P1 by P star equal to 4.955, T1 by T star equal to 1.188, and 4 FL max 1 by D equal to 11.596. For the fan of flow, 4 FL by D equal to 4 FL max 1 divided by 2 minus 4 divided by D minus 4 FL max 2 divided by D. So substituting 4 into 0.005 into 12 divided by 0.025 equal to 11.596 minus 4 FL max 2 divided by D. So calculating 4 FL max 2 by D equal to 2. Now referring to the fan of flow table again, for this value 4 FL max by D equal to 2 from table number 6.2, page number 81, you will get Mach number equal to 0.42, gamma equal to 1.4, and the gamma equal to 1.4, P by P star equal to 2.563, T by T star equal to 1.159, and the 4 FL max by D equal to 2. This is the reference value. So for this value, we have taken the properties. Now properties at exit, P2 equal to P1 into P2 by P star divided by P1 by P star equal to 350 into 2.563 divided by 4.955 equal to 181 kilopascal, and temperature T2 equal to T1 into T2 by T star divided by T1 by T star, which is equal to 323 into 1.159 divided by 1.188 equal to 315.1 Kelvin, and the C2 velocity equal to M2 into square root of gamma R T2, so 0.42 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 315.1 equal to 149.4 meters per second. The answer to the problem, velocity at the end of the pipe C2 equal to 149.4 meters per second, pressure at the end of the pipe P2 equal to 181 kilopascal, temperature at the end of the pipe T2 equal to 315.1 Kelvin. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Gas Animation Jet Propulsion. You may refer to the book for additional problem in the subject and the detailed theoretical discussion also. You can refer to the book. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture with additional problems in the fan of flow.